His wit needed no background. What could have been less promising for a setting than the witness box in the Old Bailey courtroom when Wilde was appearing as the plaintiff, accusing the Marquess of Queensbury of libel? The defense of the Marquess was in the hands of Sir Edward Carson. This attorney, or Queen's Counsel, as he was then called, by his bitter sarcasm and bludgeon-like attacks, hoped to beat down the flashing, rapier-like replies of Wilde. Wilde and Carson had been fellow students at Trinity College, Dublin, and Carson had somehow never succeeded to the heights that Wilde had scaled. He'd always been intolerant of the poet. In fact, when Wilde was told that he would be cross-examined by Carson at the trial, he immediately replied, "Ah, no doubt he will perform his task with all the added bitterness of an old friend." Carson began by speaking of a magazine called The Chameleon, to one issue of which Wilde had contributed an article.
"Listen, sir. Here is one of the phrases and philosophies for the use of the young, which you contributed. Wickedness is a myth invented by good people to account for the curious attractiveness of others. You think that true?"
"I rarely think anything I write is true."
"Did you say rarely?"
"I might have said never."
"Religions die when they are proved to be true. Is that true? Do you think that that was a safe axiom to put forward for the use of the young?"
"Most stimulating."
"Is it good for the young?"
"Anything is good that stimulates thought in whatever age."
"Whether moral or immoral?"
"There is no such thing as morality or immorality in thought. There is immoral emotion."
"There is something tragic about the enormous number of young men that are in England at the present moment who start life with perfect profiles and end by adopting some useful profession."
"I should think that the young have enough sense of humor."
"Did you become intimate with a young lad named Alphonse Conway at Worthing?" "He sold newspapers at the kiosk on the end of the pier."
"Really? This is the first I have heard of his connection with literature."
"Was his conversation literary?"
"No, on the contrary. Quite simple and easily understood. He'd been to school, where naturally he had not learned much."
"Did you take the lad to Brighton?"
"Yes."
"And provided him with a suit of blue serge?" "And a straw hat with a band of red and blue?"
"That, I think, was his unfortunate selection."
"What enjoyment was it to you to entertain grooms and coachmen? You had wine?"
"Of course."
"Was there plenty of champagne?"
"Well, I did not press wine upon them."
"No, but you did not stint them."
"Gentlemen would stint his guests."
"What gentleman would stint the valet and the groom? Do you drink champagne yourself?"
"Oh, yes, yes. Iced champagne is a favorite drink of mine, strongly against my doctor's orders."
"Never mind your doctor's orders, Mr. Wilde."
"I never do, Mr. Carson."